Well, it's certainly been a while and a half since I've posted anything here on my channel. Again, don't mind the fact that I don't have any hand tracking this time around because I cannot find my USB 3 cable for it. So, anyway, yeah, this here is just a list of stuff that I intend to do either in the near future, such as OpenGL wrapper comparison. I've already completely set up. I know you can't see where I'm looking at right now, but it's like right next to me. The entire setup for that is already complete. I just need to, I think, install one more thing and then I can actually start recording. And yeah, I guess we'll just keep on going with the stuff on the list. So I've already gone ahead and began talking about it. So, after that is the idea that I have of maybe live streaming myself trying to register program the Alliance AT3D in DOS. I know some C, but not that much, so very likely I am going to struggle hard with this, and also likely I'll probably be setting up like a GitHub repository or something to just make my code available for that. So then people that have, a little bit more experience might be able to either help along if they want to, or just look through and laugh at my mistakes in the code. All right, and after this is one of the things that I most recently talked about in one of my YouTube community posts, where I discovered that Alliance Semiconductor, or more accurately, their successor company, Alliance Memory, which was just Alliance Semiconductor, but minus everything that's not memory. Alliance Memory apparently makes eMMC modules, and yeah, I want to try turning one of those into a USB flash drive now, just because of how uncommon it is to really work with bare eMMC modules. Like, I've never seen Alliance Semiconductor's memory modules outside of anything that's not from the 90s. Or outside of anything that's from the 90s. So yeah, that might be an interesting experiment. Though that will either require some intense microsoldering, which I can kind of do. I'm still not great at it, but I can do it. I recently resoldered a broken USB micro B cable or micro B connector. And yeah, it's just an interesting experiment. It's so somewhat pricey because I have to buy like the eMMC reader board, and I want something that can support the fastest possible standard for eMMC so that then I can really push things to the limit. Anyway, alongside that, next up is my whole thing about testing a pile of old graphics cards. Let me just like grab the box here off the side. Okay, so in no particular order, I have the Trident 3D Image 9750, Assist 36, or what's it called again? 6326 from AOpen. So this, yeah, from AOpen. So AOpen's drivers for the 6326 are the only ones that support OpenGL. And this, if I remember correctly, is the Matrox Millennium 2, I think, if I remember correctly. It's a Diamond Stealth 2 G450, so it sounds very Matrox. And then after that, this is a Diamond Fire 1K Pro. Then I think I have an Intel i740 somewhere. I don't remember where. I don't think it's in this box right now. I don't know where that went. Anyway, I also have S3 Verge GX2 still in its box here, alongside a GeForce 7900 GTX and the Radeon HD 6870 from the $15 thrift store PC. But those two newer cards, I probably won't be running through the same tests as the older cards, just because they're newer, they tend to support more standards without issue, so they're not as interesting to push to their absolute limit, unless you're, like, making them do things that they're not designed to do at all. Anyway, yeah, there's that. Still not entirely sure where that i740 went. Oh well. Anyway, yeah. After that, I do also still have that data tape sitting in my shed. It's not like those rickety open air sheds that you like store tools or stuff in. This is like a enclosed shed with a AC unit and heating and stuff. So it's safe in there, thankfully. Though I do also do my soldering in there, so maybe I should think about, like, I guess, wrapping it in something to prevent, like, smoke from getting all over or something. I don't know. I do have a fume extractor, though, and I make sure that the smoke from soldering gets caught by that. So, I don't know. It's got zero documentation outside of the big old binder that I have for it. So, it's going to take a while to figure out how that thing works. And then, yeah, the whole Chrome 460 thing, I did send off a couple dies to Fritz in Germany, and he took some very nice die shots of the Chrome 460. I'll include a link to that in the description below. But, yeah, unfortunately, the Chrome 460 is still very, very much dead, and aside from the die shots, we have still made almost no progress whatsoever as far as getting the car to work again, so a little bit disappointed about that, but at this point, I really don't feel like there's much of a chance that it'll ever work again, so, unless. And lastly, this is something that I think so far I've only mentioned in my Discord server in the projects forum. I came across the One Core API extensions for Windows XP, which apparently is able to allow OpenJDK 21 to work on Windows XP. And since OpenGL 3.3 and above are kind of available on XP, especially if you use some of the very last graphics cards that support XP, which means we might be able to get Minecraft 1.21 when that comes out working on Windows XP. So, if the CPU instruction requirements are, like, insanely high, then it's not going to be all that big of a deal to push it, but if One Core API only requires, like, minimum, maybe SSE, or even i686, that would be very fun to screw with. Like, Minecraft 1.21, that could go on a Pentium 2 then if it only requires 686 instructions, though. I don't know, I haven't actually tried it yet, so there's still a lot of experimenting to do for now. But, yeah, that's about it for this video. I don't really have much else to say at the moment because I haven't been doing all that much at the moment outside of, like, just, yeah, I really haven't been doing much at all this past couple months, thanks to this semester really, whew. Yeah, this was a tough semester. What is going on with my eyes? I just looked over at OBS and my face was freaking out for a moment. I am using a new webcam, which is an old Microsoft Live Cam, but I don't know, I guess maybe my hair is getting in the way again. It's at the length where it's starting to cover my eyes again. Whatever. Anyway, yeah, that's the video. And yeah, I guess I'll probably finally start recording on the S3 Verge wrapper comparison sometime within this week. I know I'm, like, looking over there a lot. There's literally nothing to see. I'm just staring over at the test bench as if I'm expecting something to happen. But, yeah. Anyway, that's the end of the video. That's the end of the video. Bye.